Ambulance service, Portsmouth, how can I help?
Please.
Patient breathing?
Oh, yes.
And awake?
Oh, yes.
Okay, tell me, Jack, what's happened?
He's a burglar. Yeah. He's jumped out the window and supposed to have broken his ankle.
Jumped from a window?
Yeah. Trying to escape. I'm failing.
Advanced paramedic Kirsten is working alone today in a rapid response car. Her specialist training means she attends the most life-threatening emergencies.
Quebec X-ray 762.
Okay.
We've got a gentleman
who is a burglar trying to escape. He's jumped from a
top floor window. The floor is between 10 and 29 foot.
You fancy going to have a look for us, please?
Yeah, Roger. Definitely go and have a look.
Yep, ping the through to you as we speak.
Thank you.
Where is it?
Which I imagine is not his home address.
You'll have to lump.
Just send Kirsten to have a nosy for us.
Kirsten is 5 miles away from the incident. An ambulance, an additional paramedic and police are also attending the scene.
OK, what's happened?
Jumped out the window, shouldn't have been there.
Yeah.
Open fracture, left ankle.
Oh, that's quite open. Do you want to get some morphine, get some IV access? We're going to have to give pain relief and try and manipulate this leg back in.
Carry on, leg gas and air.
No one deserves it, Jack's the one again.
That's nothing to do with us, is it?
Listen, have you had any alcohol today? Any drugs, anything like that?
No, I don't take anything.
I just need to know.
We're asking you about things you're taking because we're giving you morphine.
Just a pint.
A pint?
Yeah, a pint.
What, crack cocaine? Oh, it's... I thought he was an asthmatic.
Yeah, well, I initially thought that.
Right. So we need to cut up these trousers as much as we can.
I got to say, they put the boxes on when I walked in.
We just found that out, thanks. Right, you're all covered up.
The patient's ankle is badly broken. If blood flow isn't maintained, he could lose his foot.
I'll pull it straight back so we can realign it as much as we can.
You need at least a good 10 gasps of that now.
OK, this is going to hurt.
Keep still. Keep still.
Brilliant. OK. Can we get the dog? Someone get the dog? We've got exposed bone here. Can you feel me touching your foot there?
Yeah.
Good.
Well done. A bit more comfortable.
Sometimes you actually stand there with your mouth open, wondering how the hell people are actually in this position.
Take care.
You can never judge that person, no matter what's happened or what you're faced with. Everyone deserves the best care that we can give. I'm not going to let you wait on scene too much longer. Are you happy to do everything en route? We've given TXA, paracetamol and 10 milligrams of morphine and then more morphine en route if required. OK, so I'll let you get going then.
Thanks.
I've been qualified 19 years as a paramedic. I've dealt with quite horrible, traumatic stuff. What you're dealing with is someone's son, someone's sister, mother, daughter. But at the time, you can't think like that. You do have to protect yourself.
Just both try and stay nice and calm for me, OK? Tell me exactly what's happened.
He took a lot of pills.
OK, so was this accidental or intentional?
Intentional.
And have you both taken them?
Yeah, never saw what he took.
Where is he now?
In the bathroom.
Has he locked the door?
Yeah.
I need to ask, is he feeling violent?
Yeah.
I'm organising the help for you now. Just stay on the line and I'll tell you exactly what to do next. Alpha 424, this is a Category 2 call.
For two patients who have overdosed, both conscious and breathing.
The male in the property is feeling violent.
There is a second ambulance making as well, Yvette.
Gabby and Gareth are 5 minutes away from the patients. In the last month, crews across Merseyside have dealt with nearly 700 overdoses.
I don't suppose you know if there's any previous calls to this address, over?
There's a previous to the mail a month ago. From the looks of it, he did turn violent on that call.
I think the police has a little bit of a job trying to calm him down as well.
Are you OK there? What's he doing?
He has scissors.
Oh, 424, he's...
apparently got access to scissors now and will possibly use them as a weapon.
Yeah, thanks for that. All the same.
Is he awake?
I think so, but he's already going on.
Are you in the bathroom now?
Yeah, there's somebody else here. I don't know what
it is. Who's there with you?
Hello, I live next door. I don't know. Right. He looks unconscious.
He's unconscious?
Yeah.
Might as well stop in here, haven't we?
With the scene potentially unsafe, the crew wait for the police at a safe distance.
Alpha 424, thank you. This job's just been upgraded to a Category 1.
We'll update you, I mean, no more details of it.
We need to lay him flat on his back, OK? Can you do that for me?
OK.
Just place your hand on his forehead.
Put your hand on his forehead.
Your other hand under his neck and just tilt his head back.
Under his neck and tilt his back.
And if you just put your ear next to his mouth, can you feel or hear any breathing?
Yeah,
you're right, that's fine. Just keep talking to him, you've done really well.
Sounds like there's a lot of activity going on in this house, doesn't it?
I know.
What's happening now? He's conscious.
Okay.
The girl's on the phone panicking, isn't
she?
Oh,
is she?
See you again?
You seen her?
Who's that?
There's a lot of blood. Really bad, like.
We are attached to a job. We'll go and have a quick look, though. Should we get you on the ambulance, get you checked over?
What?
She's coughing up blood. Yeah. That's serious. She needs to come in with us.
Let me just get you the bowl in case you'd be sick. I'm gonna... sorry, let me get this bowl. Come on. Come here, honey. Come on, sweet girl, come here.
Alpha 424.
Alpha 424, go ahead.
It's at our location now. We've come across a patient on the street. Coughing up a lot of blood. She is going to need an ambulance.
No worries, I'll get a running call, put in and send her through to you. I'll get another vehicle for the other job.
Obviously, thanks for it.
For the honest reason, I don't know how you cope.
Heater's on and that. How long have you been on the streets?
On and off the streets for
years. How long have you known that chap for?
3.5 years.
So,
years.
A while then. And you've been coughing that stuff up for how long? A couple of months.
How many episodes have you had?
Every day I'll do it. It's not like new. I'm supposed to go to the hospital. They've asked me to go about 3 times.
Yeah.
So I mean, you know that. They say this all the time to me, but I'm always all right.
You do need to go today.
There's something big gone wrong. So when you get to hospital, you need to stay there.
She said something about a vein in my throat.
A varices.
It might have split.
Yeah.
And it's bleeding inside.
It's good. A good job for them fellas who are patrolling then, isn't it?
No.
We were waiting for another job, so I'm glad they showed us, like.
Jesus. It's awful stuff, isn't it?
Don't be sorry.
I'm going to try and put a needle in your arm, all right, just in case there's anything you need, offers on the way. Sharp scratch, OK.
Sorry, Dad.
You're doing really well. I know it's painful. Let me just put the sticker over this, love. Thank you, darling. We're nearly done now.
Can I get my bag, please?
Of course you can. Can she have a bag, please? Thank you.
Make sure you come back.
You've got to stay there now, in hospital.
No.
999 mode activated.
A lot of people say I care too much. I think, though, that my life experience has made me strong. I don't give up. I try and treat every person the way I'd want my own family to be treated. Try and be an equal with them and support them. I want their lasting impression to say, Gabrielle helped me. She was there for me. If I can save someone's life, I will.